Hello everyone, happy Friday. It is the next video in our L.I.F.T. series, and we're not going back to the basics, we're doing something different now, and I'm excited. It's a little different in the moment because, you know, you're just seeing me right now, but we have a very special guest that's going to be hopping on here in just a few minutes, and I'm super excited about it, super excited about what we're talking about. But before we move on, you know what I have to do. Counting down in 5, 4, 3, 2.
I know you see somehow the world will change for me and be so wonderful.
Okay, so I'm very excited. Hi, Sam. Welcome.
Hi, Kaylin.
Welcome to our video podcast thing.
Thanks for having me.
For those of you that don't know who this person is, which is every single one of you, this is my brother-in-law, my big brother. I've known him for over half of my life. He's married to my oldest sister and cutest little boys, Beckett and Zane. And yeah, so he has a lot of experience with the topic that we are talking about today. And so I thought there was no one better in my mind to bring on to help me with this subject than you, Sam. So thanks for being on here. We are talking about songwriting today. We've heard back from some of you that this is something you're really interested in. And as a ministry, this is something we're wanting to do and grow in and be, you know, more diligent in intentional in. So let's go about it. Sam, why don't you just tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay, I'd be happy to. Well, hello everyone. Kaylin, thanks for having me on today.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can live up to no one better to talk to about songwriting.
No one better that I know.
Okay. We'll go with that. Okay. That's good. Well, my name's Sam. I'm a music pastor currently in Rockford, Illinois, which is a city just outside of Chicago. I am married to Kaylin's oldest sister, Kristen. She's awesome. And her and I lead worship together at our church, City First Church. We've been a part of it for about 3 years now. And we have been leading worship and doing music ministry basically since our college years, which is in the early 2000s. We have two awesome boys, 7 and 5. Their names are Beckett and Zane. And if you follow Kaylin on social media, you've probably seen pictures of them.
Been before.
Yep. So thank you for loving on our kids via social media and all that stuff.
They really cute. Everyone always talks about how cute they are. So.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's great. They have a dark side, trust me. But we love our boys. Yeah. And we're passionate about worship. We're passionate about songwriting as a part of worship, especially when it comes to the local church and the church that you're a part of. We love Mount Paran. We're so grateful for your church, and we watch it from afar. We always watch all of your Christmas services and your Easter stuff, not just to see our sister, but because the things that you guys do are just excellent. And you have such a strong fine arts culture that honestly, we just are always so blown away by what you guys do all the time. And Pastor Joey is a good personal friend of ours. And so we love your church. We love the leadership there and just all that you guys are a part of. So just happy to talk with you guys today.
Yeah. So excited. Okay, so first off, my first question is just in songwriting, what has your experience been? What all have you done, been a part of?
So I've been a part of a variety of songwriting environments. Mm-hmm. Everything from my first instrumental blues band when I was a 7th grader, or that I played bass in. We were called Orange Soup. It was amazing.
Clever.
And you know, the things you look back on and regret, but we wrote some cool music.
Juice?
Say that again.
Wouldn't orange soup just be orange juice?
Yeah, it basically would be.
That's awesome.
But you know, when you're young and being creative and having fun, you just go with seemed cool at the time. So
true.
So that was the first project I was ever part of, an instrumental blues band. And now since then, have gone on to play on a variety of albums, both bass, guitar, and singing. Now primarily focused on songwriting for the local church. The albums that I've been a part of were worship albums, but many of them had different flares. One was very rock oriented. Another one was a remake of a bunch of old hymns that we kind of modernized and kind of bridged a gap of old songs and new styles. Original songwriting, more singer-songwriter, just songs that were for simply to be creative or to tell a story, weren't necessarily for the church. And have probably played on, I don't know, a dozen or so records for that respect. And so,
yeah. So I asked that question just so you guys can know, like, he's done so many different things with it, from the writing to just being in the studio and you know, finishing out the project with people. Like, every aspect, he's seen it, from producing to, you know, the fulfillment of the projects. So Sam, what does your process in songwriting look like? Cause I get asked the question a lot from students. Do you start with the music first? Do you start with a melody? Do you start with words? How do you get inspiration? You know, things like that. So what would you say has been like maybe a process that you found that works for you, or do you like vary? Cause I know sometimes I'll get a melody that sticks, and then sometimes I'm like, oh, I like this progression. Let me mess around with some melodies or something like that.
It's a great question. And I think it's kind of this like secret code that a lot of people are always searching for and trying to find. Yeah. I've seen professional worship leaders and songwriters answer the question, and I've seen, you know, everyone in between answer the question. And what I've resolved and concluded is it does not look the same for each person.
Yeah.
And it doesn't have to look the way for you that it looks for me. But primarily, my process starts with just melody in my mind. Mm-hmm. And I grab my phone and I open up my voice memos and I record it like right away. I think that's one of the key things, whether it's a melody you hear in your head or a chord progression you're playing on a guitar or piano or bass, wherever you find it, record it, because wherever your process starts, it's essential to have that initial inspiration to come back to. So for me, a lot of times melodies will start in my head and I'll just start singing, whether it's a verse or a chorus. Mm-hmm. And I might have like one word, you know, it might be like the word faithful. And then if I don't have the other words, I'll just hum out what I'm hearing, or I'll da 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 what I'm hearing. Mm-hmm. And then you can fill in those gaps later. If it's a chord progression, I really force myself to not try to add melody to it right away. I just want a good set of chords, or I want a strong melody. Because there's really, really smart people that you can surround yourself with to help find the best partnership of those two things. So most of my songs that I've written have started as like a voice memo on my phone, driving down the road, or like right when you wake up or right as you're falling asleep. You know, we have these like random bursts of inspiration.
Yeah.
And that's typically where it has started for me. Is just like, boom, I have a thought or I hear something that I like and it inspires me. And then I just try to record it right away.
Yeah. That's awesome. And it's so true. It does vary for each person. And for me, even it's varied depending on the song, even sometimes it's one thing first and then the other. If we're looking at like lyric wise, what are just some tips you have in writing lyrics to songs?
Lyrics are like the major component.
Yeah.
Because honestly, for those of you that serve on a worship team at Mount Paran or play an instrument, you kind of find that there's a lot of very similar patterns, especially in worship music. Mm-hmm. But what separates them are very like subtle nuances in the chord world, but major, major differences in the lyric world. So for lyrics, I would say one of the most important things is to determine what is the purpose of the song. That could be, this is a song about God's faithfulness, or this is a song about miracles. This is a song about reaching people with the message of Jesus. This is a song about finding peace in God, you know, whatever the topic might be. And then making sure that that is the anchor that everything is connected to and built around. And, you know, songs need tension. There has to be a rise and a fall and then a resolve to all of the components of the song. Mm-hmm. So that's where, you know, you use Lauren Daigle's song, Peace Be Still. I don't want to be afraid. And that word afraid establishes the tension. Yeah. And then that chorus comes in and serves as the resolve of the message. Peace be still, like bam. Yeah. So there's a great dynamic there of tension, resolution. And then you can lift with a bridge, like you can take that statement of faith even farther, whatever it is. But I think one of the challenges when you're initially starting out with lyrics is you can just kind of feel like you're just like singing randomness, like, God, I love you. Thank you for dying for me. Thank you for healing me. Thank you for rescuing me. Thank you for setting me free. Thank you. Like you can, you can kind of just start to get words out, and that's a great way to start. But as you develop a song, it's important to have like a theme that anchors it, and that's going to bring purpose back to the entire song. One of my kids is knocking on the door right now.
You can let them in. It's okay. You can say hi.
Okay. Yes. Come in. It's Zane.
Oh, hey Zane. Oh, thanks. Everyone, this is Zane.
Here, come say hi to KK.
Hi, this is KK.
Hi, Bubba.
We're making a quick video.
Thanks for hopping on the call to say hi.
Say hi to everyone.
Hi.
Hi.
Did you make me something?
That's hilarious. One thing that I think is also important in writing lyrics is the continuity of kind of how you're if you're describing God or something like that, if you're talking to him, all that stuff, the continuity of how you're doing that is really important. And I know we've had conversations about that whenever I've written stuff and sent it to you and you're like, hey, you know, you give really good tips. And maybe this is going a little more intricate into the details of lyric writing, but I think it's a really good thing to always be thinking about, especially if you're just starting, catching it early on, because then it's not like you're learning something new again later down the road. So would you just elaborate on this a little bit?
I think one of the best ways to kind of like hone in on the point you're bringing up is, without that like specific goal in mind, we can find ourselves in one part of the song singing from the perspective of like, God, I love you. God, I need you. God, would you speak to me? And then we could go to a chorus that says, we are for you. We are here for you, you know, et cetera. And there's times where that perspective switch is okay. Chris Tomlin actually does that a lot in his songwriting. Mm-hmm. He'll write a verse from a personal perspective, but then a chorus many times will be more of a corporate perspective. So when it's intentional, it can be done right. And many people do it correctly. It doesn't mean that an entire song can only be about a group or about an individual. It can shift. But I think that's one of the things to keep in mind as you're structuring sections of the song is to go, okay, what vantage point is this being sung from? And you always want to put yourself in the shoes of the audience that's going to be singing with you, especially writing for the church. Mm-hmm. That kind of is the zone of, you know, songwriting that we'll focus on, it seems like, on this chat. So when we're writing for the church, we always want to be putting ourselves in the shoes of our congregation and what is something that people can sing back to God. And it can be about them and it can be about him, and it should be about both. That's kind of the starting point of like songwriting vantage point is this about me? Is this about God, or is this about a group? And then how do what are the right words to help describe, you know, what you're trying to say.
Yeah. And a lot of figuring that out comes from writing it and then having people help you. Okay, here's, you know, little tweaks that I would make, things, perspectives I would shift. That's helped me a lot in my songwriting. The last thing I want to kind of just like, I don't know, end with this is just, for people that are just starting out or have been doing this for a while, in a worship setting specifically, just what are some practical tips, some starting points, some starting tips that you have? Because this is something, like I said, we're wanting to do more of intentionally. So what are just some last, you know, encouragements or notes that you would have for them in starting this?
Yeah. I would say this, that anyone can be a songwriter. It's not like certain people have it and others don't. And different people are going to get inspired in different ways. So, excuse me, kind of like I said earlier, the way that you start a song might look different than how someone else starts a song. But one of the most important things is just to start. And it's very, very rare that like an entire song just like comes to your heart or comes to your mind, like the clouds split and the light shines through and you just write down the whole thing, you know? It's actually really encouraging as you listen to different podcasts and listen to different writers, you find out that some songs take shape over the course of like years, literally. I was listening to a podcast with Cody Carnes from the Worship Online website. And he was saying he had recorded a voice memo in his phone like 3 years earlier. And then he was in a writing session and he was listening back to ideas on his phone. And he's like, oh man, this fits on the song I'm working on right now. Mm-hmm. So don't feel like if you don't get a complete song that it's not, you know, something that could benefit you in the future. And I would just push yourself to set time aside to write. One of the things that I encourage my team with, and I say this a lot, is amateurs wait for inspiration, but professionals get to work. So it's like anything. If I wanted to be a better tennis player, I can't just sit around and hope that like by watching other people play tennis and like buying a bunch of equipment, but never getting out and actually playing tennis, like I'm not going to improve at it or ever get better at it, even though I really, really want to. So the same is true with songwriting. And be encouraged that a simple start can grow into a really elaborate finished product. So start, be okay with just having a section of a song. And then I think one of the keys for growing as a songwriter is sharing it with others.
Yeah.
And be selective with who you share that with. Kaylin would be a great person to go, hey, Kaylin, I have this idea. Can I show it to you? And like, could you just tell me what your thoughts are? And just understand that songs go on really, really big journeys to get to their final form. Even Bethel Music is a great example. Brian Johnson, he talks about in their church that they sing their songs over and over and over, in some cases, hundreds of times before they ever get to an album that we hear. And we're like, oh, it just happens. There's just like this special glitter out there that falls on the people at Bethel. No, they actually work just really, really hard at their craft. So start, be okay with just having a section of a song. Share it with someone that you trust that will give you honest feedback. And then another cool thing about the church that's really great is collaborating with others.
Yeah.
So you might come to Kaylin with a chorus and she would go, oh man, like I love that. Why don't we put some verses to it? And a partnership can help bring a song into a complete form. And I'd say the other thing is just make sure that while you're songwriting, that the ultimate goal is to seek and experience God's presence. We've all been changed by songs that carry that, you know, goal. And don't songwrite for the sake of songwriting. Don't songwrite so you can have cool videos to post on social media, things like that. One of the most important things to understand is you want to sing songs that benefit your house and your church. And that's the music that we're hearing from other churches, is they're just fully committed and fully planted there. And they're writing songs and music for that. And that's what you want to do for your home church. And then God will bless it and put it on the journey that it needs to go on, wherever it needs to go.
Yeah. Well, thanks, Sam. Thanks for hopping on the call. And
thanks for having
giving us a lot of really good insight and tips and things to think about. I'm excited and I appreciate you.
I can't wait to hear it comes out of it.
Your fancy setup. I feel like I need to step up my game, get myself a mic, maybe put on some real clothes. I have avoided real clothes like jeans and like so much. Anyway.
I take a shower and get dressed every day so that I'm staying focused.
Yeah, that's a good idea. All right. Well, I love you, Sam. And I love you guys. Thank you for just continuing to listen to these videos and watch these. I hope they are just as beneficial for you as they even are for me, because I'm enjoying learning new things and growing as well. So until next time, we'll see you guys later. Bye.